tomorrow there'll be more of us.
I'm so happy and excited to have you here. For those of you who are probably watching right now, you're probably wondering where you've seen Anthony. You know, he's made his name around Hollywood, I would say.
I've been saving up all my pennies in my piggy bank for this day.
Today's all we got, so we cannot stop. This is our blood.
You may have seen him in Hamilton, or maybe on Netflix new series, She's Gotta Have It. Or perhaps you saw him in the movie In the Heights. Anthony, welcome again.
Yes, thank you. Thank you again.
Let's start with your album. This is your sophomore album. How did you get here?
I've been really, really making music for, you know, the last like 5 years. But since I was, I love writing songs even in high school. Going into college, I was writing songs. But, I made my first album in 2019. And then this next one, I really was like, you know, my first album was really autobiographical. It was about my life. It was about a lot of events that happened to me. And it was really, really personal. And I think the second one, I was like, you know, the priority for the second one was really like, yeah. I want to make an album that is rhythm driven.
But I lose my fucking mind when you take off your clothes. I look up in your eyes like, babe, I'm about to blow.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I was like, I want something a little more grown, a little more sexy, you know what I'm saying? Like, I want to change this vibe up a little bit. And that's how I came up. That's how we wrote like 70 songs or something, 75 songs, and basically picked, you know, we picked 30, then 25, then like 18, then 14, and then 12. And the 12 songs, these 12 songs kind of, all the themes of the songs felt like they embodied this one title, which was Love and Lies. And you know, it's like what feels like love sometimes is a lie, and what we can't recognize as love sometimes is because we self-sabotage ourselves, or we tell ourselves lies and talk ourselves out of actually experiencing love. And I think all these themes kind of lined up to this one title track. And that's how we came up with the title. And the number one priority was like every song's gotta smack. Every beat has gotta be hard. Every concept's gotta be fire.
What I think is super cool about the album, and I'm sorry to cut you off, is that every song sounds different from the next. There isn't one song that sounds the same, to another. Like, I've always wondered if there is a certain way you're supposed to listen to this album. Like, should I start from the bottom to the top? Should I work from my way from the top to the bottom? Is there like a story that goes with it, or just listen to the album? All the songs are dope. Every song is like a different vibe.
I think definitely top to bottom, but what I started to find, which was flies, is because I'm very intentional about the track list. I think it's important to set the tone, right? Like, I think it's really important to walk people through, take them on a journey, you know? And for me, the first album was very storyline, and the second album was like, every song has a story, but it was more about what vibe do I want to go to next? You know, and where do I want you to begin and end at?
What would you say was the most difficult process, if there even was one, or maybe the most challenging for you when while creating this album?
Oh, I mean, the most difficult process was cutting songs.
Yeah. You know, I mean, out of 75 songs, how do you narrow it down? You must have called a lot of your boys. You guys must have sat down a long time during the night to think about, like,
a lot of listening, a lot of listening back, a lot of mixing and matching. You know, what do these 30 songs sound like together? Or you rate them, you know, I'd be like, okay, what are the songs that I have to have? And then I'll start there, and it'd be like 6 or 7. And then I'm like, okay, cool. So now how do I build off of these 6 or 7? And also thinking about themes as well. I mean, I had different track lists. There was one that was a storyline all the way through. There was one track list that really was story driven all the way through. And then the one that ended up being on the album was more about the vibe. I was like, where do we want people to go as far as just like top to bottom sonically? I just want people to just feel this mood and this vibe top to bottom. And they'll get the stories in the song. But like, yo, it's hard, man. It's hard to pick songs. It really is, you know? And I might release another album sooner than later.
You have all the good thing is, like, now you have a lot of other songs that perhaps maybe you can even use for another album, you know, or just play them in the background and jam out to it and vibe to it because you're, you know, because you can.
I'll play them at shows.
There you go. You know, it's like, yo, people, this is something y'all haven't heard before. So this is exclusive for y'all.
Everybody loves an exclusive.
Exactly. What would you say is your favorite song out of the entire album? I mean, I know that's going to be hard, but there's got to be one that you're like, yo, this is the one that's going to, like, hit hard.
That's like picking a favorite kid.
But, you know, they're always, I feel like there is always one, though. There's always one that you're like, you know?
Yeah. It changes for me sometimes, though. Like, right now, my favorite song is Right Now. You know, but...
I like Échale.
Échale is...
I was jamming out to that a little while ago, like, you know, when I was listening to the album, and I was like, man, I really like it, Charlie. I like that.
That's my joint, yo. And Control, you know, Control has been one of my, you know, my favorites. That's a super R&B, like, joint. But yeah, Echale is, that joint gets me hype. And that's my, all my friends' favorites though.
Echale. Yeah, I love it. So I want to ask you, you know, because I do, you know, talk to a lot of like reggaeton artists and stuff like that. So who would you want to collaborate in the Latin industry, both male and female?
Bad Bunny, J Balvin, obviously, you know, them cats are the big creme de la creme, you know, Tiny though.
You know, I love Tiny.
I would love to jump on the joint with Tiny. Like, I think Setch is incredible. I love Becky G.
Carol G. Or what about Paloma Mami? She's really good too. She's
Paloma, like, yeah, she's fire.
Yeah, I like her because she's got that Spanglish vibe, you know?
Yep. Yes. I mean, you know, there's you know, Rao Alejandro is you know, he's fire. I love Mike Towers. You know, there's just like, you know.
Hey, Puerto Rico, not for nothing, but you guys, like, between Puerto Rico and Colombia, I'm like, You guys are like representing La Bandera wherever you guys go. Who is your go-to person, you know, in the music business, in the music industry that you would go to for advice as far as like, you know, when you're making the album?
He's my best friend. He's my executive producer, Will Wells. Like, that dude, he, you know, and my A&R, Wendy Goldstein, is amazing. Like, she's incredible, man. Like, she's got one of the most brilliant minds, I think, in the music business. You know, my boy Will, we've been friends for so long that I think he knows me so well. And you know, he helped me craft both albums. He executive produced my first and second. And we've been working together for, you know, since 2016 now, I think. And, you know, and every now and then, you know, I'll get advice from somebody who's, you know, so other folks in the business, you know.
I read an article during the movie with Lady Gaga that she gave you an advice, and I thought, you know, it'd be kind of cool to maybe touch up on that advice that she gave you, which was to enjoy the journey before, you know, like the process that you're going through right now, because I guess I'm assuming she reflects back on those moments. Those were some of her favorite moments. So what has so far been some of your favorite moments of this journey?
My favorite moments for sure have been just making the records. I think that's always been my favorite. I think is when you're in the studio and it's just you and your friends or whoever you're writing with, it's just y'all, you know, and there's no one else there. There's, you know, you're not performing for anybody. You don't have, like, you're just starting from scratch, right? There's a blank page. You go in there. Somebody's got an idea. You have an idea. Someone else got an idea. This person got two ideas. Y'all just throw it in the pot and y'all just like, okay, well, what's the best idea right here? And I think there's something special about, I mean, there's nothing I love more than writing songs because of that. You can just explore. I feel like if this vibe is whack, let's just go to a different one. And you can move on. It'd be five vibes that are not feeling right. And then you just like, finally you get one. And then next thing you know, you do a session 2 days later, 3 days later, 2 months later, a year later. And you're like, damn, I had this chorus. You know, the first song of my first album, Dear Diary, I wrote that. Me and my boy Will sat in a studio and we wrote only a first verse of that song in 2017. And 2 years later, we brought that back.
Wow.
And it became the first song of my first album. And you just never know, you know, and I think I love it, man. I just love the process.
You know, you're kind of exploring more into the music. Is this something you're going to focus more on, or are you still going to be acting as well?
I mean, I'm definitely focusing more on music for sure. Like, If you ask anybody, I pour way more into the music than I do. I mean, I pour everything into my movies and everything that I do. Everything I do, you know what I'm saying? I give my all. But I think as a new artist, right? Like, you know, I've been doing film and television. I've been acting for like 10, 11 years now. You know what I'm saying? Like, music, I'm still a baby in the game, right? That's like 5 years. You're still a baby in the game. And I'm very aware of that. And I'm very conscious of that. And that's why I push hard.
You're Puerto Rican. What is your favorite Puerto Rican dish?
Chicharrón de pollo. I mean, I love a good mofongo, for real. Like a good mofongo, like, you know. But yeah, I love some chicharrón de pollo with rice and beans, with the aguacate. I mean, ensalada de pulpo is my joint.
Ooh, nice.
Yeah.
And what about beverage?
Beverage. I mean, you know, the classic, the mojito. If we're talking about, I mean, really, you know, anything. When I go there, that's like, I don't even drink mojitos like when I'm home, but like when I'm in
Spanish, I'm a Hispanol, right?
It's broken, yeah. I mean, I speak it, but that I speak in English in these interviews because—
Listen, we're here because we grew, like, I get you. Like, my Spanish is a little broken too, but it's okay. Like, you know, we speak right. It, so it's, you know, it works.
Yeah, yeah.
Anthony, thank you so much for, you know, giving me your time and, you know, answering my questions about your album. I wish you the best of luck. I love your voice. I think you have a very unique, you have like a very raspy, like there's a rasp to your voice that I really, really like.
Jackie at Vibras TV, you know what I'm saying? Hey, Charlie, we gonna take it all away. Turn the music up, go and grab another drink. Pull somebody close, feel a tension escalate. Let them call the cops, we gon' turn up by the way. Échale. Échale out everywhere.
Thank you so much. Thanks for vibing with me.
Yeah, no doubt. Thanks for having me.